playing with all the music.
Hush now, darling. Don't say a word to me.
I recognize that music.
Violate your soul. I'm not sorry for what will come. What you don't know.
Introducing my sister. Hello, Kingdom. Revenge, our 1 year anniversary of the opening of Kingdom of Wrestling. I'm happy to announce that Cruel Nightfire is the new hardcore champion, and I'm also happy to announce that my wonderful son retained his crown as well. One year of watching matches happen in my dollhouse. And I mean, my dollhouse. What do you want? Can you not see your queen is speaking? Well, well, what do we have here? Hello, you're queen. Duh. You call yourself queen and yet you have no subjects. At least none with their own minds. Shouting the real queen just got here. We all know that's bullshit. You have the audacity to say that. Have you seen your hive members? Of course, all of my drones are willing.
Yes, very willing. Brain motion will affect anyone.
Ophi's scoffing. And the audience is disagreeing with her. See, the issue we have here is that you are not fit to be queen. And you know what happens where there are two queens in one hive. Enlighten me. The dominant queen devours the lesser one. And you think you're the dominant one. I think that's clear. Yeah, but as clear as muddy water. Maybe we should put that to a challenge next week. You, me, here, in this ring. Not now, Dolly. Maybe later. Anarchy is, of course, shouting that she wants to play now. Emma's shouting out, you'll lose your crown to the rightful queen when the time comes. We'll see.
Somebody hit somebody. Sergei wants to see violence. Violence.
Now. How impatient we are. Your reign will end soon enough. Now hit the hive's music. Anarchy warning the hive, of course. If they get any closer, they're going to lose a limb. Well, that was interesting. I guess we all now have heard what our main event will be. The Dali, the Agent of Chaos, Anarchy versus Emma Gray, the Bee.
Yes, that should be very good, very interesting.
Although I do have to comment noticing that Sarah Jane Crowley wasn't with them this time. I wonder if she's still having trouble because of the outcome of her last match with the Hive.
Yes, someone tried to kill her recently, did they not?
I don't know if killing her was exactly what was going on, but
she was having trouble breathing afterwards.
Yes. Anyways,
so, Kingdom, I am the new number one contender, the King's Crown. I've taken on all comers since returning to Kingdom of Wrestling, and will continue to do so on my path to the crown, on my path to becoming King Poffo. Now, Dominic Surge, you name the time and place, we'll crown a new king.
It's only a drink. Sounds like you need to eat some more Soprano brains. But still, impressive. I've never heard him talk before.
Well, as you say, he is one of the undead. Maybe his voice box is decayed.
Yeah, that does happen with the zombies. And speaking of our king, there's the music for Dominic Surge, the Cyber Skull.
If the king is going to come out here and do something about the friends and the other friends, I guess, since the number one defender, the other friends, the unlikely film.
Yes, that would be correct. Well, look what we have here. The Aussie and the Zombie. I have to say congratulations to you, Joss, for becoming the new number one contender to my crown. And also to you, Cruel, for becoming the hardcore king of KOW. Normally I'm in a pissed off mood, but today I'm actually in a good mood. Since I successfully defended my crown at Revenge against the stupid cowboy Drewski, I think I deserve to see some entertainment. So as your king, I decree that you two jesters will fight one another right now. Alpha is agreeing, saying, all right, let's do it. Allow me to introduce your combatants. On my left, we have the machine gun, Josh Poffo, at a weight of 192 pounds, at a height of 6'3", from Sydney, New South Wales, Australia, pardon me. And of course, our king of hardcore, the living dead, Cruel Nightfire, at a height of 6'4", 260 pounds, from the graveyard. Let's see some action, gentlemen.
Okay.
That is very good takedown there. He got him down on the mat now. Oh, he getting back up to his feet.
Ooh.
Nasty.
So far, they're showing some skill here.
Yes. Crow gets slammed hard into corner. And the machine gun going in hard with that drop kick.
Looks like he followed it up with a super kick. Gauging what he's going to do next. And there's an Irish whip to the far corner from Kroll. Followed up by a big boot.
And he has a nice set of knee strikes. Break the ribs, break the ribs, crack them.
Softening up that midsection.
Yeah, the zombie may be falling apart, but right now he is also picking apart his opponent.
And there's some lovely head smashes as he introduces him to the turnbuckle. Referee is counting and is up to four. Needs to get him out of that corner. And, oh, no, banana abuse, followed by a lovely headbutt, only a two count, but damn.
Very nice comeback from the Josh Buffo, but, what are you thinking over there, King? What do you think so far of these two individuals?
Well, Kroll has always been a difficult opponent to keep down. He can take, lots of punishment. Of course, he's a zombie, that goes without saying. But right now, in a figure four leg lock, even his legs, if you break them, they don't move too well. He may not feel it, he may not care. But he's still not standing. And of course, Mr. Poffo, no slouch. He's obviously capable as a fighter. He is the number one contender for the Kingdom Crown. So these two in the ring, really, about the only disadvantage I would say Kroll has is that it's not a hardcore match. So he does not have as many weapons or tactics as open to him legitimately as he could in a match like a hardcore match.
I just wondering if Kroll gets broken bones, being a zombie, does the broken bones heal?
From what I understand, it takes a lot of very special voodoo.
Ah.
That's depending on the kind of zombie. Well, it depends on the kind of zombie. If he's a viral zombie, then maybe he just needs some additional brains or whatever. It's so hard to say. Zombies are so... There's so many types. Ah, I'm hearing from the back that Gorilla Glue is involved. Lots and lots of Gorilla Glue. But well, back to the match, that work. Continues to keep it up, but gets hit with a throat thrust. One of my favorite moves. And is now doing what every zombie is well known for doing, and choking themselves in Ozzy. Better he choke an Aussie than to choke a chicken. Alrighty, from what I understand, seeing here, we're doing some more choking. Always a good move, especially if you're fighting among the living. Followed up by a toe kick. And now a arm wrench hook kick. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Hearing further news from the back. And Krull saying that's the end. And we get a one, a two. Nope, only a two count. Yes, according to the back, there was a mistake. It is not Gorilla Glue. It's Gorilla Press Glue, as this is a wrestling fed after all.
Who other than Bart said that I'm going to Gorilla Press them later? Terrible, terrible joke.
Attempt by Krull to get an upper hand. But instead gets hit with a code red.
And did the referee tell him that too close to the ropes? Referees have said that to me before. I never believed him. I never believed him. The referees make stuff up.
Well, you know, really, when you think about it, as a wrestler, it is really bad show. Ah, the Regalplex being used. There's a one, a two, and a kick out. But still, you know, it makes sense. Why do any kind of pin attempt near the ropes? It just gives your opponent too many opportunities to get out of it. Best to bring them into the center of the ring where they have no hope.
It's what I usually do. I beat them up in corner, I hit them left, right, center, then I throw them to center of the ring and they're done to finish them. Speaking of finish stuff, I think Josh could finish things here.
Well, it looks like it. Oh. It would seem that,
oh, she wouldn't have made joke? Well, I'll get her press a little. Talk him with a little.
As Josh snaps the fingers of the zombie over there, they're continuing to fight it out. Vendetta's just staring at them as they fight. Krull being dragged over to the corner. A wonderfully performed Tiger Suplex. Followed up by some stomps. He's grabbing him and dragging him back out into the center of the ring. But
taking your advice, sir.
Yes. And he's going into it, looks like, yes, he is going to try and force him into a submission with a cloverleaf. But, wait a minute, is that the Sydney cloverleaf? My apologies. But, I'm noticing something. Is that an object in the ring?
Now Juice falls into the lounge himself to get distracted by the vendetta.
Yes, but, you know, in most cases I would say don't pay attention to the person on the side of the ring. But this is vendetta. Turning your back on her could be deadly.
Oh, and that is so sad to see. Josh Popo lost the staring contest. He blinked.
Yeah, well, you know.
Oh, and there's the sister Abigail. And now he may lose match too.
He lost.
First the staring contest, then the match.
No, again? He allowed himself to be distracted. Yeah.
It's only a drink. It's only a drink. It's only a drink.
Two losses in one day.
It's only a drink. It's only a drink. It's only a drink. It's only a drink.
Well, what a choice. And he made it. It's a tactical error that cost him the match. Not that Green Lantern.
He looks like Green Lantern.
No, he doesn't nearly have enough CGI. And of course, his opponent. Run!
Como te llamas, baby? Desde que te
visité,
que eras pa' mí. Dile a tus amigas que andamos ready.
No
lo seguimos en el
after
party.
Como
te llamas, baby? Desde que te visité, que eras pa' mí. Dile a tus amigas que andamos ready.
Yeah. expect to see a lot of action here, gentlemen. All we need now is our lovely referee. Tend not to ask a woman what she was doing in her private time.
This is gonna be a
mess. And there we go. She's in and meaning business, meaning throwing that ring into action immediately with a bell ring. Two gentlemen are now lining up. And there's the accept. Heidi. The two men circle for a little bit and lock up. Nice to see these two men are actually showing some respect for each other. Considering they're from a similar school of wrestling. Now it looks like a lockup following up into a wrist lock. Following into a hammer lock and then a snapmare. Lots of Irish whipping and rolling about. Sorry to be so quiet. Watching two gentlemen of this caliber toss each other around has made me all a fluster.
Calm down, relax, find yourself. Take a drink of cold water. You'll be okay.
It's okay, I brought some blood with me. I'm good. An excellent Hurricanrana followed up by a pin. Good up high.
Ray is poised, he is ready to attack.
Neon getting up and getting caught with a flying crossbody. Another attempt to pin, although he didn't stay down. Still, this is what we would expect of two luchadors. Fast pace, quick attempts, Irish whip as they both go into corner.
I tell you, I am very surprised to find a butterballs of holy. I did not know butterballs had anything to do with religion.
Oh, you know, there's the fear turkey that I hear is basted and sent to the Vatican. But only after some weird vampire has done horrible things to it. Alrighty, but back to the action. We have a top rope hurricanrana being done by Neon Shadow. Excellent, excellent. Lovely execution. El Rey getting up, looking a little out of it.
This time Neon fights to attack.
Oh, a diving arm drag. That has to hurt with all that momentum.
Oh, absolutely. It looked very painful.
And of course, a quick stomp to keep him down. Ooh, a lion salt. Nicely done. The new guy is really just... Ooh, a standing moonsault into a pin. Excellent. But still only a two count. Still, he's keeping the pressure on, and that's what he's got to do if he wants to make his debut, one that he can take away with a win. Alrighty, a toe kick followed up by a shot to the ropes. Both men meet in the middle, and there's another toe kick. And, uh-oh, tried to use that weak rebound real kick, but got caught. Although he still got hit with an enziguri, it was a nice try to turn that around. Another pin attempt. Still only getting a two count. They are working this match like you wouldn't believe. But this is the kind of action we come here to see. A small package. One, two, and still no shot.
Awkward.
That's right, folks. Yeah, this is the kind of action we come for.
Only a small package because they're not Russian. Russians have big package.
Stardust press.
Johnny Wrestling! Johnny Wrestling!
Still only a two count. And no, I'm not going to comment on the size
no,
of
but
the
I, package. No, but I saw your eyes glance over this way as I said that. I noticed.
Ooh! Sky Twister Press. Nice. Going in for another leg attempt, another pin attempt. One, two, barely gets a shoulder up though. He's wearing him down. As for your package, sir, I'll have you know, I'm into girls.
That's okay. I am to girls too. We can make some arrangement.
Followed up by a toe kick. And a leg lariat.
Yeah, but on the action, yeah, this guy very good. Both of these very good. I like what I'm seeing here.
Nicely done. I mean, really, these two are really doing well. Ooh. Okay, Neon Shadow is signaling for the end. Let's see what he comes up with. Climbing up to the ropes. Looks like he's setting up. Waiting for his prey. And... Oh! A Neon Shadow stomp. That was like a coup de grace plus. And there we go. Taking the three count and the win. Your winner by pinfall, Neon Shadow. Congratulations on his introductory match and taking away the win.
Very much so. Welcome to KOW. Good job.
And as for you, sir, as far as arrangements go, certainly turn your innie your outie into an innie and grow some boobs and we're fine.
I used to have boobs, but I lost some weight.
Hey, and there we go. A handshake of respect between the luchadores. As it should be.
Gonna be a match to remember.
Well, hello there, my friendly little clown. Sergey, would you please be a doll and read for our darling Akira?
I could do that. Hello, Yuki-chan.
Hello to you too, Akira.
So, the hive's been beaten down somewhat, I see.
Well, they're certainly missing at least one member. But never say they're down completely. As we saw, they're still here. They're still annoying. But for now, at least they know Shrine Maiden and the Demon Clown are a force to contend with. And they'll maybe, just maybe, give us time to breathe, time to train, and time to walk other paths. Yes.
I agree.
Some of us have...
other paths?
Some of us have a different fate, a different destiny awaiting me. Take care of Rena. Train hard, train well. I will be there in the shadows to help you learn to use your clown abilities and to help keep you, well, as close to sane as any of us can be.
I see. Suddenly gets a blush across her face. Akimi says she wants to play with you sometime.
Oh, I bet she does. Little minx. Anyways, I'm not leaving. I'm not disappearing. No. I'll be here, accepting the challenges as they come. Just not in the ring as often as I used to be. I'll be instead gracing that wonderful chair over there, giving my wonderful comments and laughter to all of you nice folks. But that doesn't mean that I've become a pushover or that I am still not the demon. Cross the line, and I will come into this ring and tear you a new one. And anyone who goes after the Shrine Maidens, thinking that my protection is gone, is sorely mistaken. Anyone who goes after them, or crosses me and my family, are crunchy and good with ketchup.
Nothing. Right, and you'll have both our support. Me, Rina, and Akimi. Thank you for helping us.
Of course. I got you into this mess. It is the least I can do to stick by your side. And Rina's. And I'm sure that my darling kitty behind you, Saki, will agree. We don't abandon family. Speaking of families, oh, of course, I'd be happy to.
Give me one to a hug.
Now, speaking of families and such, I seem to have a family member that is interested in some playtime. Matter of fact, I even put on these darling kitty ears just for the occasion.
Oh, make me over. I'm all I wanna be. Oh, I can study.
I'll try not to.
Well, there's the bell, and now we will get underway with the action. They're both in the center of the ring, looking each other over. Ariel Purin a little bit. I do not speak kitty language, but Ariel definitely have some kind of words for Yuki.
You kiss your mother with that mouth?
I guess Yuki knows what she said. Now they exchange punches. Ariel reporting back with no, would you? Don't think we want to know what Yuki would do. Ooh! A shove!
Bitch!
Ooh, and a nasty dropkick to the face. Ariel using all those limber kitty muscles to full effect. Yuki growling as she is dropped to the mat. Oh, and we mentioned Gorilla Press earlier. I guess the kitty was paying attention from the back and got an idea. And there goes Yakuki? What the? I am very kooky today. There goes Yuki back down to the mat. You have to forgive me, English not my first language. Yuki gets him back up to her feet. Both these women very agile, very limber. Ooh, and there's a drop to hold, and now Ariel feels the mat. Yes, right, yeah, you can't blame me, right, Saki? Ariel down once again at the hands of Yuki. Ooh, and a nasty drawback, jawbreaker. Front face lock applied. Slowly dragging her towards the corner. Yuki with the dropkick of her own, returning the one she got earlier. Now she is climbing the turnbuckle. What is on her, the demon's mind? Demon clown. Of course, a cat bounce in the form of a coup de grace. Puppy. Now the cat girl in a little bit of trouble. Good thing cats have 9 lives, right? Oh, and the famous her.
Look at the pretty kitty butt.
I'm looking at many pretty butts in the arena tonight. Ooh, and some stomps for good measure. Ariel feeling every single one of them. As she gets up, she gets in a punch and another punch. And here comes the combinations. And he snaps the plex. And now suddenly Yuki finds herself in a little bit of trouble. There's some good back and forth in this match so far. Ooh, an inverted pile driver. And you could just feel that one all over the place. That may have rung Yuki's bell quite a lot. And Ariel clearly very happy with herself right now. Now she's a blind lion tamer. Mia right in there and checking to see if Yuki want to tap out. Does not look like the clown is ready to give up just yet. She's trying to drag Ariel as she tries to get towards the ropes. And she does, Mia begin the count and Ariel breaking pretty quickly. Now they look up in the center of the ring. Nicely applied wrist lock. Always nice to see all the technical stuff. And now Ariel has the Hammer Rock applied. Yuki Rebexon into one Baron. Ariel in some pain, little worried about maybe possibly getting a paw injury. Now Yuki sending Ariel into the ropes. And Ariel coming off and getting the armbar takedown. You can tell she definitely kept girl with how quickly she moved there. Yeah, she definitely been improving. She learning new things. Oh, and she wrenching at the arm. The way she wrenching, she may be showing a little bit of an aggressive streak there. She wanted those cats that will claw your face off. Yuki trying to fight back to get to her feet. Ooh, and a nasty super kick. Yuki going in for the pin. And the one, a two. Ah, no, no three, not this time. I think the referee taking some heat from the crowd. Some crowd thing maybe should have been three. And a drop to hold. Yuki back down on the mat, and I think she saying something about her nose. She may have hurt her nose on the landing there. Hopefully not broke anything. Ariel again very pleased with herself. And those series of headbutts. And some, as they would call it, muffin booster. Yes, the referee counting as a choke is applied. Clearly a choke. And she gets up to four. Yuki shoves Ariel to the ground. And now, the darkest of dreams is applied. Yuki said night night, Kitten. Mia is asking if she wants to tap. She may have to, it looks like it's a locked in tight. She either has to tap or she will pass out. Yes, yes, she has passed out. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, the clown, Yuki. Oh, Yuki is certainly on the roll this week at Revenge. She made Sarah Jane Crowley tap out and out. She has... the Catwoman Ariel Carter to go
in the lights, I won't say you're safe this time. Here and now, you're mine tonight.
I present to you our main event. Scheduled for one fall, submission, death, destruction. In order of their appearance in the ring, at a height of 5'3", 110 pounds from Belfast, Northern Ireland, the drone of the hive, Emma Gray. And of course, to my right, in the pink, the dolly known as the Agent of Chaos, at 5'10", 165 pounds from the Eye of Terra, Anarchy Warblood. You both know the rules, although I doubt you'll give a damn. Mia, may God have mercy on your soul.
This is gonna be a match to remember.
And the bell rings and we will get going on this one, our main event for the evening. And we saw earlier when Ophelia and Anarchy were out here, Anarchy very eager to play.
Yes, and an opening with a heartbreaker followed by a quick cover, trying to make this a quick an easy win, which we know isn't going to happen.
It's not going to happen, but you can't really blame her for trying to end this early.
No, I can't. Although, since dollification, I don't know, Anarchy's not quite had the same vicious streak she used to have. I am amazed that Killer B has not been removed from the ring yet.
I don't know about that lack of vicious streak. Didn't Anarchy and Emma have a match in the hardcore tournament, which had some very painful moments for Emma?
Yes, it did. But at the same time, I remember my very first match. And I remember being thrown into the ring and out of it and into my opponents, used as a bat, all by Anarchy.
Yeah, okay, well, that part of it we have not seen in some time, but I think there's still a very vicious streak within her.
Well, let's hope it wakes up soon, because right now Emma is definitely in control. Of course, after the Hive's loss at Revenge, they have a lot to, take revenge for.
Yes, and again, we may make note of the fact there is no sign of Sarah Jane Crowley.
Ooh, and Inzaguri puts the bee back on the mat. We may finally start to see the doll do some playtime. What? What are you staring at me for, sis?
Well, there is a headbutt from Anarchy. Followed by a couple of more.
Oh, boy. You know, that's a very compromising looking position to be in.
Just twisting and torquing that neck.
Checking to see if the parts come off.
And you say that vicious streak is gone. She trying to rip Emma's head off.
Oh, yes, this is true. But here you can see Emma is fighting back. Ouch! and counters with a jawbreaker.
I find it funny that Anarchy is trying to see if Emma come apart. Anarchy is the doll right now. Don't dolls, like, come apart?
Not all of us do, hon. See?
But your arms aren't detachable, your legs not detachable.
No, they're not. Well, more correctly, they're well designed and not coming off.
Ah, well, okay, that's a good thing, I guess. Anarchy sent into the ropes. And the ropes there's a number ticked down.
Yes. Again, you know, I'm really hoping to see that, you know, Anarchy's going to turn this around. Of course, secretly, I've always been an Anarchy fan. Actually, not so secretly. So I'm really hoping... Okay, yes, I'm obviously an Anarchy fan.
Getting corrected by your sister. Always fun.
Yeah, if she only knew the kind of things I'd kept a secret. Oh. Back to the match!
Well, you're trying to get killed, Yuki, aren't you?
Woo! And there was a DDT performed by the Bee. She goes for a pinfall attempt. Still only getting a two count.
Going to need to do a little more work. Trying to give her doll some encouragement. I don't know, she's running out of playtime. Anarchy again off the ropes, and this time getting a drop kick to the face as she comes back. Grabbing a hold of the foot, and she's going into the figure four leg lock.
Very, very painful. Of course, it's not as much of a submission hold as people like to think it is. I mean, let's face it, we've seen it applied in this ring many, many times, and no one ever taps.
Oh, but no. It's about inflicting pain.
It's about inflicting pain or reversing it and inflicting pain on the inflictor.
Well, I've never had it reversed on me. No one has managed that yet. So for me, it's all about inflicting pain. And Anarchy gets to the rope. She's got the ropes and Mia is counting. Emma's going to have to break it.
Now, I will have to give some props to Killer Bee. She has not once entered the ring or tried to interfere with the match. Of course, with the Queen there, I don't think she wants to challenge Ophi quite directly. So it's easier to stay at ringside, but still... It is interesting to see her only observing her drone and not taking the opportunities to tilt the match into their favor.
And Anarchy with the drop toe hold, which causes Emma to get caught up on those ropes.
Never fun when you bounce off the ropes like that.
No, definitely not.
Okay, we've got a pickup from behind. Looks like Anarchy's finally going to start playing. Woo! And there's some playtime right there.
Yes, I'm near with the count because obviously I'm very much on the ropes. Ooh.
Oh, no need for the ref to hurry and count that. No. She can take her time.
Emma again getting choked on those ropes.
Our queen shouting encouragement to her doll.
Of course, we expect her to continue to encourage.
Oh, and performs the atonement. Another attempt at a pin, only getting a two count. This is going to be a tough match, seriously. I mean, as much as I may make fun of the Hive, and as much as I may give Emma particularly a hard time and say horrible, lewd things and stuff, I do have to give props that their wrestlers do understand the sport, and they are decent competitors. They are opponents to be not taken lightly.
Absolutely, I could not agree more. Killer B has got herself a good little hive going on.
I know
very
that
effective and very powerful.
I know that any time I am in the ring, as we watch cravat knees being put to the face of the bee, anytime I'm in the ring with one of the hive, I understand that this is going to be a tough fight. Just as if I was in the ring with Anarchy, I would expect the same. Or our queen, Ophelia.
Yeah, I got to be honest, it's never a wise idea to underestimate your opponent. I have done that a couple of times in the past myself, maybe not taking an opponent as seriously as I should have, and ended up losing match.
As there's an Irish whip into the corner, sending the bee into the turnbuckles. In by a hard corner smash, sending the bee to the floor. Referee starting the corner count. As once again, we have someone being introduced to Mr. and Mrs. Turnbuckle. They're a lovely couple. A little hard on the head, though.
And now the snake eyes and Emma bouncing face first right off that turnbuckle.
Yeah, that's never fun. Well, it's fun for Anarchy, but not fun for the one she does it to.
Ophelia may be getting a little ahead of herself, trying to ring the bell.
I think she was saying more along the lines of ding as in the sound of the head bouncing.
Ah, well, maybe. I don't know.
I see Anarchy is up on the ropes, waiting. Yep, Emma's head bouncing off the turnbuckles. Emma turns, faces, and gets hit with... Oh! Hold on. That did not look like it went as expected.
She managed to get out the way just in time.
Yes, and has now super kicked the doll to the floor. Both handlers, I guess you could say, are clapping for their appropriate their individual members. You know, my sister's gonna not like this comparison, but it's almost like watching two dolly masters at work. One just dresses her dollies up as bees.
Do you hear that, Queen Ophelia? You're very much like Killer Bee. Except with different fashion sense.
Well, yeah, and she's cute. Well, let's see. There was a grab at the mask, it looked like. Rope shoot being done. And a... Oh! There was an attack sending both of them over the ropes. Both handlers moving in, keeping an eye on each other to keep the at a minimum as the referee starts her count.
Anarchy giggling.
Anarchy gets up.
That is generally never a good thing.
No, usually when Anarchy is giggling, that usually means there's a problem for the person she's giggling at.
Oh, yes.
If I remember correctly, last time Emma had her giggling, she got very intimate with the barricade.
Yes, and she is up against that fence. We may see a repeat of what we saw before.
Oh, my. As much as I like watching the bee get hurt, that just hurts to watch.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no.
I think if Emma suffers that again, she may need surgery this time. And Mia is up to 9.
And there it is, a double count out. But are they going to stop? The match is over with a no contest, no winner.
I wouldn't put money on it.
And there is a bee sting done by Honey. By the queen of the honeybees. But our queen has pulled out her royal scepter.
Oh, this could get very messy very quickly.
I believe this is a good hint. Uh-oh, wait a minute. More is happening. Weapons are being pulled out. This could be bad. Well, bad for them. Lots of fun for us.
As long as they don't get too close to us.
No. We got two with chairs, one with a barbed wire bat. The question is, are they going to play? Looks like Emma's considering leaving. Looks like the Hive is going to do the smart thing and not take the risk.
Yeah, they seem to be thinking better of it, thinking maybe save it for another day.
Better part of valor. Better to leave now with their stingers between their legs than to get a barbed wire bat for the face.
Yeah, it sounds like the bad choice.
To go get him. And there she goes backstage. The crowd yelling for the Horde!